woman really needs, what the woman really needs, is she needs nurturing from her man. She needs to be known that she's appreciated, she's loved. Those things that she do mean something to him. If she gets that, she's full. She's full. It's really simple. Us men make it complicated because we're complicated in what we want and what our things is. But it's not. It's really simple for them.
And you mean full of everything. Happiness.
Yeah. She's good. She's good to go.
Rest.
Once she's sure that that man appreciates, loves, and respects her, she's good to go. She's absolutely good to go. But getting to that point is where the adversary work us over in the church.
Oh, yeah. You're telling the truth.
You know, getting to that point. Amen. Because once she get there, he know he has a solid relationship that he can't bust up. So then his goal is to keep me from getting there. That's why people struggle so in the church, and I keep telling them, hang in there. Well, I don't like the way they're doing that. This ain't going right. That ain't going. That's okay. Hang in there. You serve a God that know how to turn everything around in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. But you have to hang in there. If you don't hang in there, then the adversary will bust up your stuff. And I mean, he be on it too. Yes, sir.
I was just going to say, that's where about 5 out of 7 holidays belong to the females.
Those are shop days.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Only 2 days we get is birthday and Father's Day.
Yeah. We get Father's Day if she laughs.
Right.
So she's up early and she's preparing things while it's still dark. And she's getting together stuff for her family for that day, so that they can go ahead and do that day. And this is what she does. Verse number 16 says, she considers a field and buyeth it. With the fruit of her hand, she planted a vineyard. Now this does not mean that the man is laying around doing nothing and she's out working and, you know, taking care of things. What it's making reference to is that when you look at the word considerate, that means she's given some thought to this particular, we'll say, project, this particular thing she wants to venture out on for her family, and for her husband and her family. And she understands, you know, what needs to be done to make it happen. She don't just do things haphazardly. She's given thought to them. Women are very meticulous in thinking of things that they can do and things that they can prepare for their households, for the husband and the household members. So this is what it's making reference to, that she don't just jump up and do something. She's giving it some thought. All right. Verse number 17 says, she girded her loins with strength and strengthened her arms, so that those things that she needs to do for herself in order to be better for her family, for her husband, she does. So she ain't just out all times of the night roaming the street. She at home. She's taking care of those things at the house. She has to prepare stuff so they can go to bed. So while they go get in bed, and she start getting stuff ready for tomorrow, that she can get ready, you know, before tomorrow get here, so that it's already done. So she's already doing this stuff. I remember on Sundays, you know, my wife used to get out what I was going to wear, underwear, t-shirt, socks. Doc, all I had to do was get up, slide down the pole into the outfit, walk to church. She did. Now, again, these are things that were done. It don't mean that if you ain't doing that, you ain't virtuous. So I'm just giving you some clues as to some things that were done that so to say, we would say wasn't even necessary. She didn't have to do it, you know. But that's where her mind was as far as doing things. And young people, especially in this day, because this is a weird day to be in a relationship, because people in relationships now, they don't really know what relationship means.
That's right.
They just think like, you know, Now we do it to one another, then we just cool. You know, it ain't about a relationship or involvement and things that we do to you know, they don't look beyond 2 days from now. You know. And in a relationship, you look at the relationship for the long term workings of the thing. You know, where you going to be at in 20 years? Where you going to be at in 30 years? And that's what you're working and building up to, you know. And one of the formulas that people don't calculate when they are dealing with one another and seeking and getting married is how the kids will impact their relationship. So when the kids come in, the relationship is going to change. But it needs to change, but it also needs to retain some of the elements that it had prior to children. That, you know, you need to be able to go somewhere and cuddle up and do what you did to make those children without the children knowing. You know, you need to figure out something. So the older they get, the more you have to sneak away. You know, because they can hear noises and just, you know, figure things out. You know, now you're too ashamed because, we got children, they're going to know. You know, hopefully they're not further along in it than you are. Hopefully. Because in this day, it's hard to tell. Amen. I know some folk about 17, 18. They doing some stuff. You know, I know Robinson ain't never even envisioned. But hey, it's tough. All right, so she's strengthening herself. Now the reason she's strengthening herself, because she has total responsibility of the family's well-being. It's not for her. It's still for them, but it's for her, for them. Yes, sir.
What is the indication of her loins?
Her body.
No, I mean, I was just saying that she strengthens her body.
She takes care of her body. She takes care of her physical body. She looks after it. Of course, the loins are just your waist, actually. That's your waist area. All right, verse number 18 says, she perceived that her merchandise is good. Her candle goeth not out by night. So now what it's saying is she recognized that those things that she's doing for the increased betterment of the family is going forward. So she will continue in those things. She will not drop them. She will not drop them. She will not allow something to interfere with those things that are keeping the family in a forward progress motion. She's just not going to allow it. Now, it is true though, and I want to say this because I need to say this to men, because men will have their wives working with one foot over in the grave. If she's sickly, and you should know whether your wife is sickly or not, then you can have a virtuous woman that does none of these things. She can be virtuous in her own right, in her ability, in as much as she can perform what she can do.
That's right.
So don't go home with the list. You know, your wife's got cancer, she's down and out, and the doctor don't think she's gonna live till next week. And you got a list saying, you ain't virtuous because you ain't done these things. Because Pastor Hill said, don't do that to her. Let the Holy Ghost give you some wisdom, brothers. Some wisdom, you know. You find out she ain't feeling good, give her a break. Don't tell her, you had a headache 2 years ago. Don't do it like that.
I would do it.
To what?
That would be important.
Okay, so her candle not going out means she continues with those things. So in order for her to know that a candle, and listen to what he's saying, a candle does not go out by night. In order for her to know that a candle is lit, she has to get up periodically and check it. So she's constantly on the go. She's constantly keeping up with those things that are essential for the doing and the betterment of her family. And I do say family, okay? All right.